There's something going on in the universe right now that is creating big shifts in a lot of people's lives. From my perspective, it looks like we are all being asked to start to align with our higher calling and leave behind these false senses of security, of success, of societal ideals, and connect with something much deeper. Watch this video. So, if you're new to my channel, welcome. Please don't forget to push the subscribe button and share if you feel like you want to. But for those of you that have been with me for a while, you know some of my story as of recent, this past year, and I'm going to use some of that story to share this new insight that's coming forward for me, for all of us. So I'm hearing from a lot of clients, a lot of clients, all ages, that they are being asked to go somewhere else that's uncomfortable. We are being asked as a collective to let go of our external false sources of security and safety. And we are being asked to do this so that we can start to trust, even though it's hard to trust when you lose these things, right? Trust and align with our higher calling, with the work that the universe or source or God or whatever it is that you call it wants you to do. That call from your soul, that purposeful soul call that's like, this is what makes me feel fulfilled. I can't tell you how many clients I coach that have the perfect life, the big dream houses everywhere, the cars in the garage, the perfect children, perfect dogs, perfect job, perfect image, but are not feeling fulfilled at all. And what I love to call this is this ideal versus real, this ideal that we were brought up believing, this conditional reality, right? I talk about it often. This conditional reality that says, if you do these things, you'll be successful. If you're successful, you'll be enough. If you're enough, you'll be happy. But what's so messed up, I was gonna swear, but I won't. What's so messed up about it is everyone who does this, not everyone, but most people, I mean, some people are still asleep, they're not awakening, but when you start to awaken and get in touch with your authentic feelings, you can't deny what you're feeling and you can't deny that this isn't working. So people who are waking up and seeing that this path still makes you feel like something's missing, I still don't feel enough, I still don't feel totally true to myself, I still don't feel blah, 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 blah. The reality is it's because you're not aligned with who you truly are, what you truly came here to do. You're aligned with the societal view of something that's not meant to be your calling. It's meant to be your job or career or status. And so when we realize, we start to wake up. I have this new client this week who was telling me she's starting to wake up now and she's scared to death of owning the new authentic truth because she's afraid of losing all these things that have made her feel enough and safe. And so this is where my story comes in. A year and a half ago, we lose our house in a fire. This house brought me great joy. The house is still standing, but the area was so bad and circumstances, we had to go. So we lose our ability to live in this house because of the damage. And I'm devastated because this house brought me so much joy. It was, for me, everything that I wanted. I had such joy with my dogs and my family in this home and built my business in this home. And it really meant so much to me and it was gone. And then this year, I have to move away from a place that I'd lived for 20 years, to new town, new state. And my identity, who I became for 20 years, was in this place, and all my friends, and I had to go. And then recently, my dog, who's my soulmate, who's in most of my videos with me, abruptly gets a terminal illness and 6 weeks later passes away. And now I'm in this place where so many of the things that brought me so much joy are gone, but I'm going to be honest with you. What I feel is strong, what I feel is that I'm the same. And in fact, I feel like I might be more. Because now what brings me so much joy is, yes, I get to see how those things that I had that brought me joy, my identity wasn't in any of them, but who I became was. I got the love and the joy from these places. And so my love and my joy is not gone. Who I am is not gone. Who I am is wherever I go. And when I was telling this client from very real experience, I was telling this client, she was like, Candace, I have these huge homes, I have these buildings I own, this business that I own, I look great, I have these sick parties with the perfect food and the perfect bartender and the perfect music. She goes, but then I'm not at my party because I'm worried about, is everything perfect? And I'm not having fun at all. And I said, because your reality is the opposite of what I just explained. Your reality, which is so many of our realities, right, is based on my externals to give me my identity. Her external is in how successful her business is, how beautiful she looks at her age, how her kids are acting, how high-end the catering is, what the make of the car is. Without even knowing it, her coping strategy to feel enough is to make sure this image is perfect. This is so many people. And what we're being called to do is get the fucking images out of the way so that you can stop being perfect and start being authentic. You can stop being ideal and start being real. For me, a lot of those things were taken, so I had to live into the experience of what it really feels like to just be with yourself and feel how amazing and fulfilling and true and real and raw and enough that really is. So I just wanted to share that the way to our calling is by letting go of the things we thought were our identity that are outside of us, or our security that's outside of us, or dictated by any condition. Your calling was born into you. It's your soul. It's who you are, regardless of any stuff, regardless of any status, regardless of any anything, regardless of how your relationship is going, because it's a lot of identity for people, regardless of the size jeans you're wearing, regardless of anything, your calling is still waiting for you. And the way we tap into that calling is by tapping into these real feelings. Hey, I'll use my client as an example. I have the perfect party, I'm not home. Where the hell am I? Why did you leave? Why can't you be present? What do you really want? What's your real feeling? What really brings you joy? And instead of being afraid of that because of what that'll take from you or how it'll change your life, it's time to be loyal to your soul and dive into how you feel and do that inner work. And when you do the inner work, you can start to live from the inside out. And then if you lose your house or you lose your freaking dog that you're in love with or you lose your whatever, you're still on your calling and you're still in purpose and you still feel full and happy and enough and alive. So I hope you guys take that message and vibrate higher. I love you so much. Please check the links below. Please subscribe and share, and I'll see you soon.